What's going on, guys? This is Steve here at Big Pop Aquaponics. I just wanted to help give you an update of the greenhouse and the plants and the system and how it's going so far. And I have to say, I'm really happy with the flowers that are going on right now and the fruit. So let's go ahead and take a look. All right. So these are all cherry tomatoes, and I have fruit galore on the plants. And more fruit coming. The next one we got is right here. We're looking at vine ripe tomatoes. So let's make sure you can see those. Yeah. So these ones are gonna be your salad tomatoes and everything like that. But the big daddies, you're making some BLTs. Here we go. We got us some beef steaks right here. Yeah. I got a bunch on up there. All the way up, and got some more cherries here. Cherries seem to grow really well, so cherry tomatoes, if you're in Florida and you want to use some tomatoes, I'd say cherry tomatoes. As long as you keep them watered and they get enough sun, you're looking good. What else? We also got some peppers going on. So this one right here is a Tabasco pepper. That pepper, it shot up, but it was real skinny on the leaves, so I kept cutting it back down, and now we're looking really bushy. As well as we got some basil going on right here, and then more peppers. And this one actually has about 7 peppers on it, so yeah, you gotta love it. We did do some upgrades inside. As you can see, I have my timer going on. It actually just shut off behind me, so it's working. And we're looking at some temperature and relative humidity. So right now we're a little bit above 60 and the humidity is not too high at all, but maybe 12, 13, but that's how the plants are doing, guys. Oh, I almost forgot. If you ever want to make some mint tea, anything like that, that's what you're looking for. Because the mint is delicious. So, it's really strong, but it's great for tea, ice cream, anything like that. Didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself. And I didn't know I was lost. I didn't know I was lost. So this is one of the biggest updates. I'm sure you already know from the thumbnail, we had a disaster. It's really sad. Not only did I lose fish, so you're looking at economics. I could have sold those fish. The fish feed my plants. So when you lose fish, it's bad. On a number of different levels, because they're also my fish. I love these fish. I take care of the fish. And it just makes me really upset. We lost a lot. I still don't know exactly what happened. I'm still trying to find out what exactly happened, but close to like 12 to 15 almost. So it was really sad. I wasn't even thinking about adding it to the video, but I want to keep it real with you guys, let you know the things that happen, stuff does happen, and you have to continue and move forward. But the fish that I have right now are doing well. I almost lost all the cichlids out of this tank. And this one, as you remember, it was full of cichlids. Now I think I might have 6 to 8 left. I still have a lot of babies though, so that was the plus. Is I was breeding them, so I have babies, so being able to continue with these guys is going to be a lifesaver, a money saver, basically keep me going without having to buy new fish. I'll be able to put my female back in with my male who did survive. So I'll be able to go ahead and add some more females from down top, down bottom here, with this female up top, so I can start breeding more cichlids. It was rough, but you know what? Stuff happens, and it's part of life, and we'll move forward.
Not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game made for everyone, and love is the prize. So wake me up when it's all over.